Blackstone Publishing presents Voyage by Stephen Baxter. This book is read by Kevin Kenerly. From my nephew, William Baxter. Prologue. This is Ares Launch Control, Jacqueline B. Kennedy Space Center. We've passed the 6-minute mark in our countdown. Now at T-minus 5 minutes, 51 seconds, and counting. Ares waits ready for launch on Launch Complex 39A. We are on schedule at the present time for the planned liftoff at 37 minutes past the hour. Spacecraft test conductor has now completed the status check of his personnel in the control room. All report that they are go for the mission, and this has been reported to the test supervisor. The test supervisor is now going through additional status checks. Launch operations manager reports go for launch. Mission Control at Houston reports that all systems on the Ares orbital booster cluster are also nominal and ready to support the mission. The need to be in plane with the cluster to enable the docking is imposing a tight window on today's launch. Launch director now gives the go. We are at T-minus 4 minutes 50 seconds and counting. At launch time, you may wish to look out for flights of pelicans, egrets, and herons from the marshy land here on Merritt Island. 40 years ago, Merritt pretty much belonged to the birds, and they're still here, although nowadays they're disturbed every few months by a new launching. It has taken 9 Saturn VB launches so far to put the Ares complex into orbit. Today's will be the 10th, so nesting isn't so good anymore. T-minus 4 minutes and counting. As a preparation for main engine ignition, the fuel valve heaters have been turned on. T-minus 3 minutes, 54 seconds and counting. The final fuel purge on the main engines has been started. That's the vapor you can see there, billowing across the launch pad, away from the Saturn booster. The liquid oxygen replenish system has been turned off, so we can pressurize the tanks for the launch. The wind is below 10 knots, and we have a thin cloud layer. That's pretty nearly perfect launch weather, well within mission parameters. It is typically hot, humid Florida weather here on this historic day, Thursday, March 21st, 1985. T-minus 3 minutes, 40 seconds and counting. I am told that there are an estimated 1 million here with us today, the largest turnout for a launch since Apollo 11. Welcome to all of you. You might like to know that among the celebrities watching the launch today in the VIP enclosure are Apollo 11 astronauts Neil Armstrong, Joe Muldoon, and Michael Collins, cosmonaut Vladimir Viktorenko, along with Liza Minnelli, Clint Eastwood, Steven Spielberg, George Lucas, William Shatner, sci-fi authors Arthur C. Clarke, Ray Bradbury, and Isaac Asimov, and singer John Denver. We're sure you aren't going to be disappointed. T-minus 3 minutes, 20 seconds, and counting. Ares is now on internal power. Coming up on T-minus 3 minutes. T-minus 3 minutes, and counting. The engine gimbal check is underway to ensure that the engines are moving freely, ready for flight control. T-minus 2 minutes, 52 seconds. The liquid oxygen valves on both stages have been closed, and pressurization of fuel and oxidizer tanks has begun. T-minus 2 minutes, 25 seconds and counting. The liquid oxygen tanks are now at flight pressure. Coming up on 2 minutes away from launch, T-minus 2 minutes mark and counting. 2 minutes from launch, the liquid hydrogen vent valves have been closed, and the hydrogen tank's flight pressurization is underway. T-minus 1 minute, 50 seconds, and counting. No holds so far? Capcom, John Young has just said, "Smooth ride, baby," to astronauts Phil Stone, Ralph Gershon, and Natalie York. Mission Commander Stone has replied, "Thank you very much. We know it will be a good flight." T-minus 1 minute, 35 seconds, and counting. T-minus 1 minute, 10 seconds, and counting. All liquid hydrogen tanks are at flight pressure. T-minus 1 minute, mark, and counting. The firing system for the sound suppression water system will be armed just a couple of seconds from now. The firing system has now been armed. T-minus 45 seconds, and counting. T-minus 40 seconds, and counting. The development flight instrumentation recorders are on. We're still go with Ares. Astronaut Stone reports, "It feels good." T-minus 30 seconds. We're just a few seconds away from switching on the redundant sequence. This is the automatic system for engine cutoff. T-minus 27 seconds and counting. We have go for redundant sequence start. T-minus 20 seconds and counting. Sound suppression system fired. Solid rocket boosters armed. T-minus 15, 14, 13.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.